tout ce qu'on va pouvoir dire, voilà, pourra être retenu. Ah, Nico, très jolie. Très... Elle était très, quand même très belle. Hein. C'était une. C'est un monument, un monument à la gloire d'une de. Je ne sais pas. En fait, elle a incarné tellement. Oh là 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 là. Donc voilà, hein, tu peux, tu you switch on, you switch it on.
Yes, c'est bon. Et donc là, on entend.
Oui, voilà. If you up, okay, and then voilà, I just have to put on your microphone, your magical microphone. Let me see, because I have to set up. Oh là 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 là. D'accord. Donc, alors, just to make sure. So I have to switch between this file and that other file. One, two. C'est intéressant. Tu as vu, j'ai fait des petits effets comme ça. J'ai coloré la banane. Parce que je me suis dit, je fais ce que je veux, Lou Reed. J'ai essayé de prendre la photo de Lou Reed où il était le moins à son avantage. Parce que j'aime beaucoup Lou Reed. Mais
il faut qu'il,
voilà, en même temps,
il faut qu'il redescende un petit peu quand même.
Ben, alors là, il est monté. Là, il est sans doute au paradis. Mais voilà. Mais je pense que voilà, lui aussi, s'il était à ma place. Ah, tu cherches le. Ah oui, c'est le tien.
Oui, je cherchais.
Oui, j'étais en fait. Là, comme ça, j'étais là en train de me dire. Donc voilà, left, right.
Le masque,
hein.
Le masque, je voulais dire le casque d'ailleurs, on est bien.
C'est give me a cask. give me a cask and I'll tell you the truth.
Est-ce que je m'entends?
Can you hear me, my tutom? Can you hear my?
Allô?
Tu t'entends?
Allô?
Ça va? Il faut se réhabituer à l'entendre. L'important, c'est qu'on s'entende bien. Pour l'instant, on s'entend bien.
Ça fait.
Alors, donc, tu es l'invité mystère, donc pour l'instant, tu es encore occulté.
Job. Ok, je ne dirai pas qui je suis alors. Faudra que tu me files le lien, que je l'envoie tout de
suite. Ah oui, le lien. Très bonne idée. Alors, pour cela, le plus simple, c'est que tu ailles sur. Ah ben oui, c'est pas une mauvaise idée tout
sur
ça.
Sur Facebook. J'imagine.
Tiens, pendant ce temps, tu sais ce qu'on va faire. Je vais faire le truc et pendant ce temps, je vais mettre. Je vais mettre un montage que j'avais fait en l'an 2000. Voilà, autour d'images d'Andy Warhol avec la musique du. Velvet Underground, et bien sûr, je suis sûr que tout le monde a. Everybody will recognize what song.
Je fais un petit
tac. And in the meantime. C'était ma première webcam.
Good, your European son. You spit on those under 21. But now your blue cars are gone. You better sit so long. Hey, hey, bye, bye, bye. You made your wallpapers green. You want to make love to the scene. Your European son is gone. You better sit so long. Your clouds treat you goodbye.
Sterling Morrison avec la moustache, ça va vite. Doug Yule, un des quand même héros à oublier, Nico, on est d'accord. How do you define a group like this who moved from hearing to Jesus in two short years? How would you define that? Well, that's a question that I must ask you later on. Okay, let's close that Facebook page. Heureusement que c'est que les micros sont pas ouverts parce que là ce serait
je me posais la question en fait. J'étais en train de me demander est-ce que les micros sont ouverts, voir. Est-ce qu'on y est ou pas, parce que j'ai cru comprendre qu'on y était mais on n'y est pas.
Alors ben je pense que non. Non bon, écoute en attendant voilà parce que il est 25. It will happen very soon. It will happen very soon. I don't want to watch and see how many people are watching basically at the same time. It's not useful. Because we you know all that jazz is meant to be watched by the people of the future. Moi, à la base j'étais ça, je me disais.
We are the only one who live in this time. This is our time.
This is our time, and I hope it can be shared. That would be great. And I'm going to put offer. If you have a question, ask. Just ask. Just as simple as that. Hop, and then I post. T'as, depuis que j'ai appris l'italien, en fait, je ne sais plus parler.
Mais alors, tu as appris l'italien à partir du moment où.
Quand j'ai rencontré Agnès.
D'accord. Voilà, tu t'es mis avec Agnès, tu as appris l'italien.
Bah oui, je me disais pour essayer de mieux la comprendre. Je dis bien essayer. Parce que, bon, une femme, on ne doit pas essayer de la comprendre. On ne doit même pas chercher à la comprendre. A woman is not meant to be understood. It is meant to be. You have to care for a woman because she.
You have to experience.
You have to experience it because a woman is life. Basically, it's all about that. How do you define a group like this who moved from hearing to Jesus in two short years? Elle est ambiguë cette phrase parce qu'on peut se dire ah est-ce que en gros on doit définir comment on doit répondre à cette question en deux courtes années ou bien enfin voilà c'est l'ambiguïté c'est pour ça bon, après.
Moi j'avoue que je vois le groupe enfin pour moi le groupe qui fait Jesus c'est le groupe qui fait Sister Ray ce sont deux groupes différents pour moi.
It's a hot topic, and we have to deal about that. C'est la question de qu'est-ce que le Velvet Underground en fait? Parce que bon, c'est ce groupe voilà qui a fait travailler des journalistes, qui régulièrement il y a des numéros spéciaux de tous ces magazines qui recyclent les vieilles choses, copier-coller. Hein, c'est quand même la ligne, c'est la ligne éditoriale du journalisme contemporain. Avec tout le respect que j'ai pour les journalistes, hein, on a du très bien. Mais qu'est-ce que mais aujourd'hui que serait le Velvet Underground aujourd'hui? Enfin, le Velvet Underground existe. It can exist. Sorry for those, parce que I think they can hear us. Some people they can hear us. That watch the introduction. Oh gosh, I forgot the bloody countdown. 15 minutes of fame. So. Shall we go for 50 minutes? Voilà, this is the first false start that crying out loud. Bon, alors. Tu vas aller aux toilettes? Ok. Tu sais où ça se trouve, hein? C'est tout au fond du couloir, tu dois passer dans. Enfin, tu vois. Ouais, attends, je bouge. Pendant ce temps, je vais peut-être accorder mon violon. Ou en profiter, parce que je ne l'ai pas fait tout à l'heure. C'est. I have such a busy life at the moment. It's just really, really hard to, you know, to do what I want to do. Hop, la pince à bien fermer, parce que sinon le petit après, voilà, tu tires, tac. Don't be afraid.
Les toilettes, c'est ici.
Alors.
Ah, il y a une autre porte, d'accord, okay. Merci.
Ouh là, c'est pas. One, two. Sol, ré, la. Oh là 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 là. Ré. Ce mi la ré sol si si il y a de l'humidité hein, le...
Ah ça c'est déjà des...
j'étais un peu bas hein, tout à l'heure quand on faisait Jesus.
Ah peut-être je t'avoue que je m'en suis pas rendu. On m'a pas entendu aller aux toilettes? Si
si.
Ah d'accord, parfait.
Ça fait. Ah,
tutu. Pou.
Ah, Jésus. Jésus-Christ. Bien. Bon, on y est presque, on a pris
tout tard.
Hein? We're a bit late. Sorry for those who might... watch this introduction. Are you coughing? Do you have sort of virus or something? Are you sick?
I'm a cougher.
Sick and pedantic. Okay, no worries, no problem. Alors, shall we start with la première? Ce qui était prévu, oh Seigneur. Alors, c'est ce qu'on va faire. On va. Okay. Ces câbles. J'ai l'impression que, la musique, au final, c'est juste voilà, du matos. Là. Tu prends des choses d'un endroit vers un autre et tu câbles. Voilà, c'est ça, c'est la réalité de l'existence, c'est câblé. On en est où là au countdown? Ok. Bon.
Donc tu vas lancer.
Sous peu. Alors je vais voir. Une fois qu'on est. Once. Yeah, we need to be ready. Let's forget about time. Let's forget about this timeline or whatever. So, and let's switch back to what we need to know. J'ai envie d'offrir des cadeaux à tout le monde. Là, en ce moment, c'est le truc. Là, c'est un type de, dans moins d'un an, c'est Noël. So that I'd love to provide gifts to people. You know, mostly people I know not, because most people I know, I don't want to give them presents, you know. Okay. Oh là là. On avait dit 8-16, hein, c'est ça? Donc à 8. 19, 18, 17, 16, 15, 14, 13, 11, 10. Gosh, in the meantime, that bloody phone turns. Oh, I hope I won't have to. Oh la 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 la. Walter Jeffers avait atteint sa limite. Nous étions à la mi-août. Il était donc séparé de Marsha depuis plus de 2 mois. Bilan de ces deux mois de séparation, trois lettres écornées et deux coups de fil longue distance, très chers. Certes, à la fin de l'année, quand elle était retournée dans le Wisconsin et lui à Locust, en Pennsylvanie, elle avait juré une absolue fidélité. À l'occasion, elle sortirait avec des garçons, mais juste pour s'amuser. Elle lui resterait fidèle. Mais ces derniers temps, Waldo avait commencé à s'inquiéter. Le soir, il avait du mal à s'endormir et quand il dormait, il faisait d'horribles rêves. La nuit, il restait allongé sans fermer l'œil. Il n'arrêtait pas de se retourner dans son lit, sous son édredon protecteur, les yeux noyés de larmes. Il imaginait Marsha, ses vœux de fidélité vaincus par l'alcool, par le baratin de quelques néandertaliens. Marsha succombant finalement aux multiples arguments de la torpeur sexuelle. C'était plus qu'un esprit humain n'en peut supporter. Les images de l'infidélité de Marsha le hantaient. Des fantasmes diurnes d'abandon sexuel infiltraient ses pensées. Et le truc, c'était que les gens refusaient de voir la vraie personnalité de Marsha. Lui, Waldo, lui savait, il la comprenait. Il connaissait tous les coins et recoins de sa psyché. Il l'avait fait sourire. Elle avait besoin de lui, mais il n'était pas là. L'idée lui vint le jeudi précédent, les parades des mimes. Il venait de finir de tondre la pelouse des Edison et d'en fignoler les bords au sécateur pour $1.50. Il était allé voir dans la boîte aux lettres s'il y avait « ne se fût-ce qu'un petit mot de Marsha ». Il n'avait trouvé qu'une publication « d'Amalgamed Aluminium Company of America », s'enquérant de ses besoins en store et au vent. Eux au moins se souciaient suffisamment de lui pour écrire. C'était d'une société new-yorkaise. On allait partout avec le courrier. L'idée s'imposa à lui. Il n'avait pas assez d'argent pour aller dans le Wisconsin, par les moyens habituels, certes, mais pourquoi ne pas s'envoyer lui-même par la poste? C'était absurdement simple. Il s'enverrait par bateau, en colis recommandé, avec livraison assurée. Le lendemain, Waldo acheta l'équipement nécessaire au supermarché. Du papier cache adhésif, une agrafeuse de tapissier et un carton de taille moyenne, juste la bonne taille pour une personne de son gabarit. Il se dit qu'il devrait pouvoir voyager à peu près confortablement sans trop se cogner. Quelques jours pour respirer, quelques trous pour respirer, un peu d'eau, peut-être quelques encas à grignoter la nuit, ce serait probablement aussi bien qu'en classe touriste. Le vendredi après-midi, Waldo était prêt. Il était soigneusement emballé et la poste avait donné son accord pour venir l'enlever à 3 heures. Il avait écrit « fragile » sur le colis. Roulé en boule à l'intérieur, sur le coussin en mousse qu'il avait eu l'intelligence de prendre, il essaya d'imaginer l'expression d'effroi, mêlée de joie, sur le visage de Marsha, quand elle ouvrirait sa porte et verrait l'énorme paquet. Elle donnerait un pourboire au livreur, ouvrirait le colis et trouverait son Waldo enfin là, en personne. Elle l'embrasserait, peut-être irait-il voir un film, si seulement il avait pensé à ça avant. Soudain, des mains saisirent le paquet sans aucune délicatesse et Waldo se sentit plein d'optimisme. Il atterrit lourdement dans un camion et le voyage commença. Marsha Branson venait de terminer de se coiffer. Ça avait été un week-end très éprouvant. Il ne fallait plus qu'elle boive comme ça. Cela dit, Bill s'était bien conduit. Après avoir conclu, il avait dit qu'il la respectait toujours. Après tout, c'était la nature, avait-il ajouté. Et bien qu'il ne l'aimât pas, il avait de l'affection pour elle. Et puis, ils étaient adultes l'un et l'autre. Oh, tout ce que Bill pourrait apprendre à Waldo. Mais Marsha avait l'impression que cette histoire datait de plusieurs années. Sheila Klein, sa meilleure amie entre toutes, poussa la porte de la véranda et entra dans la cuisine. « Oh là là, il fait un temps bizarre aujourd'hui. Je vois ce que tu veux dire, je me sens toute poisseuse. » Marsha resserra la ceinture de son peignoir en coton bordé de soie. Avec son doigt, Sheila picora des grains de sel sur la table de la cuisine, les lécha et fit la grimace. « Je suis censée prendre ces pilules de sel, mais... » Elle fronça le nez, « ça me donne envie de vomir. » Marsha entreprit de se tapoter sous le menton, un exercice qu'elle avait vu à la télévision. « Bon Dieu, ne parle pas de ça !» Elle se leva de sa chaise et alla prendre un flacon de comprimés vitaminés rose et bleu sur le rebord de l'évier. « T'en veux un ? C'est censé être meilleur que le steak !» Après quoi, Marsha essaya de toucher ses genoux. « Je ne boirai plus jamais de daiquiri !» Elle renonça à toucher ses genoux et s'assit, cette fois, plus près de la petite table où était posé le téléphone. « Peut-être que Bill va l'appeler, » dit-elle en réponse au coup d'œil de Sheila, qui se mordillait une cuticule. « D'accord. » après hier soir, je me disais que tu l'aurais peut-être largué. Oui, je vois ce que tu veux dire. Une vraie pieuvre, ce mec. Ses mains partout à la fois. Elle leva les bras devant elle, comme pour se protéger. Le problème, c'est qu'au bout d'un moment, tu en as assez de le repousser. Et puis, après tout, je n'ai pas vraiment cédé, ni vendredi, ni samedi. Alors, d'une certaine façon, je lui devais. Tu vois ce que je veux dire? Elle se mit à se gratter. Sheila gloussa la main sur la bouche. Il faut que je te dise, ça m'a fait exactement pareil. Et même au bout d'un moment, elle se pencha et murmura, j'en avais envie. À présent, elle riait vraiment. C'est à ce moment-là que Monsieur Jameson, de la poste de Clarence Darrow, sonne à la porte de la grande maison en bois enduite de stuc. Marsha Branson alla ouvrir. L'homme l'aida à porter le colis à l'intérieur. On lui signa ses reçus jaunes et verts. Il repartit avec un pourboire de 15 cents que Marsha avait trouvé dans le petit portefeuille beige de sa mère dans la chambre. « Qu'est-ce que c'est à ton avis ?» demanda Sheila. Marsha se leva, les bras croisés dans le dos. Elle regarda fixement le carton marron qui trônait au milieu du living. « Je ne sais pas, » dit-elle. À l'intérieur du paquet, Waldo frissonnait d'excitation en écoutant ses voix étouffées. Sheila passa son ongle sur le papier cache adhésif qui traversait le carton en son milieu. « Pourquoi tu ne regardes pas l'adresse de l'expéditeur pour voir qui l'envoie ?» demanda-t-elle. Le cœur de Waldo s'emballa. Il sentait les vibrations de leur pas. C'était pour bientôt. Marsha contourna le carton et lut l'étiquette avec les pattes de mouche à l'encre. « Bon Dieu, c'est Waldo qui l'envoie !»« Ce connard !» dit Sheila. Waldo tremblait dans l'attente de la suite. « Bon, bah tu ferais mieux de l'ouvrir, » dit Sheila. Elles tentèrent toutes les deux de soulever le rabat agrafé. « Oh, grogna Marsha, il a dû le clouer !» Elles tirèrent à nouveau très fort sur le rabat. « Mon Dieu, mais il faut une perceuse pour ouvrir ce truc !» Elles recommencèrent à tirer. « On n'a pas de prise !» Elles se tenaient toutes les deux devant le carton, immobile, haletante. « Pourquoi tu ne dois pas chercher des ciseaux ?» dit Sheila. Marsha courut dans la cuisine, mais elle ne trouva que des petits ciseaux de couture. Puis elle se souvint que son père avait toute une collection d'outils à la cave. Elle fonça au sous-sol et revint avec un grand coupoir. « C'est ce que j'ai trouvé de mieux, » dit-elle, à bout de souffle. « Tiens, vas-y, fais-le. Moi, je suis morte. » Marsha se laissa tomber sur le canapé recouvert de peluche et regarda et poussa un grand soupir. Sheila essaya de passer son outil entre l'adhésif et le bord du rabat, mais la lame était trop épaisse. Et puis, il n'y avait pas beaucoup d'espace. « Bon Dieu, ce truc !» dit-elle exaspérée, puis en souriant. « J'ai une idée. »« Quoi ?» dit Marsha. « Regarde, » dit Sheila, en se touchant la tête du bout des doigts. À l'intérieur du colis, Waldo était la proie d'une telle excitation qu'il pouvait à peine respirer. Sa peau le picorait à cause de la chaleur et il sentait son cœur battre dans sa gorge. Ça n'allait plus tarder. Sheila se redressa et contourna le carton. Une fois de l'autre côté, elle se laissa tomber à genoux, saisit le coupoir par ses deux poignets, prit une profonde inspiration, puis elle plongea la grande lame dans le milieu de la boîte à travers l'adhésif, à travers le carton, le coussin et en plein dans la tête de Waldo, qui se fendit légèrement et cracha de petits arcs rouges dans la lumière du matin sur un rythme lent. What a story! That was really interesting to hear that story in French. Sorry, I rushed. Je suis allé vite parce que voilà, je suis pressé comme ça. J'ai une journée, vous savez. Là, il y aurait de quoi raconter une. You know, I have enough to tell to write a short story like that. You know, it's the gift. You know, you Velvet fans, you know the gift from the album White Light,
White Heat.
Oh! Who's talking? Who's there? it's my mysterious guest. C'est mon invité mystère. Voilà. Donc ça va être compliqué parce qu'en fait, je vais parler anglais, français.
Et je vais essayer de faire pareil.
Yes, of course. He said, I'm going to try to do the same as I do. And beautiful story. You can find it in, this is the French version called La Parole de la Nuit Sauvage. This is an anthology, I don't know, I don't care, from Lou Reed. The original title is Between Thought and Expression.
Between thought and expression.
Lies a
lifetime.
Definitely. And that's what it's all about. It's about lifetime. It's live stream on YouTube. It's the big return, the return of les compulsions monologiques de Joseph. Le retour des compulsions monologiques de Joseph. I spent the summer in a foreign country, and that was fantastic. That was just great. You know, I ate a lot. But I managed to balance all that. It's okay, it's quite fine. You know, it's strange because on the screen we still can't see you. What's your name, mysterious guest?
My name is Benjamin.
All right. Benjamin, can I call Benjamin. You Ben? Benji?
Of course.
Benji, do you play banjo, Benji?
I don't. I actually play guitar.
You're a guitar player. And you are a, well, you're a Velvet Underground fan, aren't ya?
Yeah, of course.
Great.
I wouldn't be there if it wasn't the case.
Yeah, great. We met a few months ago. I guess it was in November, last November.
Mm-hmm.
You answered an annonce. I put an annonce. I don't know the word in English. Gosh, you know, I was an English teacher. There's some words I have utterly forgotten. Never mind. You replied to an annonce, and because at that time I was working. I'm still working on the film, a film, a science fiction, a documentary science fiction. A film, science fiction documentary film, and then we met there, and that was fine. Well, in a few words, how could you explain that experience in a few short sentences, if you don't mind?
It was a very mysterious announce it was pretty exciting, and I thought I'd get there because. The only thing you have to do was to sing a David Bowie song, and I knew how to sing a David Bowie song, not all the David Bowie songs, but one David Bowie song.
You like David Bowie, and that's good news. Good news.
And I came there, and I met a lot of strange and eccentric people.
Definitely.
And that was fascinating, and I don't regret it at all.
Good. And in the end, you were chosen to play a role
in
this film. We are low budget. You know, it's I'm working at it. It takes a long time because I'm very, very busy. I'm a very busy person. I have family, I work, I create, and here I am. That's the story of my life. That's the difference between wrong and right. Oh, just great. So tell me about Velvet Underground, because I think most people who are currently watching that show, web talk show, live streaming on YouTube, are into the Velvet Underground. So tell us how, well, the first time you listened to the Velvet Underground, what the heck happened?
It was actually in my young adulthood.
Yeah. How old were you?
I think I was maybe 20 or 21, maybe 19.
Yeah, same as me.
Sure.
Just the same. Just amazing.
I was getting out of teenage.
Yeah.
When I was a teenager, I had a really bad taste in music. I was what you can call a new metal victim. A new metal victim.
Oh gosh. Yeah.
And I know it was a hard time for me.
Mm.
I found the Velvet Underground.
Gosh.
Je voulais refaire ma culture musicale. I wanted to have
rebuild his musical culture.
Exactly.
To get born again to good taste.
And so a girl I kind of loved told me that quand je dis aux gens que j'écoute Lou Reed, les gens pensent que j'écoute Laurie.
So hard to translate.
Laurie, which is like...
Laurie Anderson. You mean Laurie Anderson?
No, I mean Laurie, the actual Laurie, who is a French singer, like a million times worse Britney Spears, let's say,
okay,
like this.
All right, yeah, some trash woman expression of...
She told about Lou Reed, and I was in love with this girl, so I thought I'm gonna listen to Lou Reed.
I saw your hand. No, it's okay. Great. You're humanoid.
Now
you're human.
Knows that I'm white.
Benji, now it's great. Beautiful story. You know, it's more or less about that. You know, my love for the Velvet Underground more or less was because or thanks to a girl. You know, I love women, we love women, it's a lurid song, it's kind of fun. Yes, so good. See, that was the same. I remember the precise day I discovered the Velvet Underground. It is my turn. It is my turn, and it's time to unveil you. Voilà. We do things, you know. People who follow my adventures on the Compulsions Monologiques de Joseph, they wissen dass etwas passiert. Anything can happen, and sometimes it's just not in order. I'm not here to order chaos. I'm not here to promote chaos. I'm here to preserve chaos. See what I mean? You know who I am talking about. Here you are, Benji. Welcome. Hello. Welcome in my humble little room. Thank you. In my room. And yes, I remember I was given a tape. I was in love with a girl. You know, shit happens. And she told me, you like David Bowie, you should listen to the Velvet Underground. I was like, I heard about Velvet Underground, you know, and the name. You know, I read some articles, but I never listened to an actual record. And I was like, okay, yeah. And she gave me a tape. You know, at that time I was still with my Walkman, as we say in France. You know, where you put your tape in it and then you walk around. Walkman, it sounds logical.
Walkman is an English Walkman. Word also.
Say that, yeah. Good, it's like flipper. Or j'entends alliage. And yeah, the day I discovered Velvet Underground, it's written in this little diary, this little silly diary. It was on Tuesday, the 25th of January 2000. And I remember precisely on that day, during the night before that day, it snowed. It had snowed in Montpellier. I was in Montpellier. I was a student in Montpellier. And Jesse, picture yourself. Here, you're here. Well, I was stoned because I was high. I was smoking weed at that time, and then you open window and you put that tape in this Walkman, and then you hear for the first time, the Velvet Underground. So that was the compilation. That was the Velvet Underground words and lyrics by Lou Reed. So it started with Waiting for the Man, and you're like, wow, oh well, it's like this very modern music. And then Femme Fatale. Then you have Femme Fatale. Oh, Femme Fatale. Just you hear for the first time in my life. I heard the voice of Nico. Nico, I heard her voice. While walking on the snow.
Such a great voice.
And she was, you know, just imagine. You know, some of you might know. You experience something like that. I'm sure. And then we move on to Heroine. And you walk in the snow, you're high, and you discover Heroin. And then All Tomorrow's Parties. And you're like, and you're 20 years old, you know, and there's part of me who will always be 20. I will be 20 forever. So that's a nice story, isn't it?
Here she comes. You better watch your step. She's going to break your heart in two. It's true. It's not hard to realize. Just look into a false colored eyes. She'll build you up to just put you down. What a clown, 'cause everybody knows
she's a femme fatale.
The thing she does to please,
she's a femme fatale.
Just a little tease,
she's a femme fatale.
See the way she walks, hear the way she talks. You entered in her book, page number 37, have a look. She's gone to smile to make you frown. What a clown. Little boy, she's on the streets. Before you know, you're already beat. She's gone to play you for a fool. It's true, 'cause everybody knows
she's a femme fatale.
The thing she does to please,
she's a femme fatale.
She
just a little tease.
She's a femme fatale.
See the way she walks. Hear the way she talks. 'Cause everybody knows
she's a femme fatale.
The things she does to please.
She's a femme fatale.
She's just a little tease.
She's a femme fatale.
Oh, oh, oh.
Gosh, that was gorgeous. It just brings back a lot of memories to me. Oh, thank you, Benji. I put on my glasses because I have tears in my eyes. And if you want to, because when you're a Velvet Underground
fan...
The light fan,
is pretty heavy, I gotta say, so I'm gonna put on my glasses,
yeah,
too.
Yeah, you know, we're here, we pay tribute to the Velvet Underground, we pay tribute to what we wear when we discovered the Velvet Underground, and we pay tribute to something that will always remain. Okay, good. Okay, my turn now to sing a song, because it's going to be like that. We're going to sing songs by the Velvet Underground, but... Not only we're going to sing songs about the members of the Velvet Underground, because the Velvet Underground is a whole, it's more than a band, it's history. You know, nowadays you don't have a lot of bands that can, you know, that can turn into history, because you no longer have journalists that can write properly. They can copy paste and they do a great job with that. No, don't take it personally to the journalists, but I think, yeah, that there's something is missing. Nowadays, voilà, c'est ce que je pense. Je le dis pas en français parce que du coup ça pourrait vexer des journalistes français. Voilà, parce que bon. Mais en tout cas, oui. Qu'est-ce que je disais? Oh gosh, I forgot. We're running out of time. Never mind. My turn to sing a Velvet Underground song. Oh, thank you, Benjamin. When I first saw you on, you know, for this. What's the name? I forgot. You have something. That's why I chose you. I invited Moby. You know, because as you know, I'm later we'll talk about that. But I know people. Well, last time I did a special David Bowie celebration, and my guest was Tony Visconti. So I have a good feeling with the Bowie people. You know, the actual Bowie people. And it's a bit dirty. Sorry. And Moby was supposed to come, and finally, because of all the problems we go through these days, there are some virus and all that. You know, people from the future, they'll notice that, they'll know that or not. We'll see. But he couldn't come, and then I thought, but gosh, I have a real Velvet Underground fan, and well, I criticize journalists, but you're also a journalist. But anyway, let's move on to another song. Otherwise, it will take 3 bloody hours. But I would go for that. You know, we had the l'apéritif, and then we have to eat, and there is le petit, my son. You know, he mustn't go to bed too late. Okay, let's move on to that song. It's a Velvet Underground song, but Lou Reed, like many of you know, like demos and unreleased songs by the Velvet, Lou Reed later re-recorded them. But this one is one of my favorite songs, and there's a beautiful demo. It's from 67, and it goes like that. Never been to London, never been to France. Never was sorry. Oh. Shed to life, take 2. Never been to London, never been to France. Never was sorry, never learned to dance. Never walked down to 47th Street and France. Never smoked any filtered air. Guess it's true what all the people say. Guess it's true I have to change my old-fashioned way. I guess it's true. I guess I live the sheltered life. Never walked about on the street at night. Never got into an uptown fight. Never smoked a hookah, never saw a rug. Couldn't even squash a beetle bug. Guess it's true, I'm gonna have to change my ways.
Guess it's true what all the people there say. Yeah, I know it's true. I guess I live the sheltered life. Never went to parties in a chauffeured car. Never wore a top hat 'cause I won't get far. Never learned to handle all the things that I've seen. Maybe I'll grow up to be big and mean. Guess it's true what all the people say. Gonna have to change my old-fashioned ways. Well, I guess it's true. Guess I've lived a sheltered life. Oh, I guess it's true. Guess I've lived a sheltered life. Damn it! Maybe I lived a sheltered life. That's a question I had. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you, mates. Des fois, je me pose la question, je me dis, putain, est-ce que en fait, dans ma vie, j'ai pas eu une espèce de vie finalement très rangée I guess I lived a sheltered life, but no, actually no, I had fun, you know. I discovered the Velvet Underground when I was 20, and then I moved to Paris because I was so, like, cocked up, you know. And I was like, okay, let's go to Paris and let us try to be a... you know, let's try to play rock and roll, you know. Because that's a great thing with the Velvet Underground. First, when I discovered that band, I understood that it was not only about sex, drug, and rock and roll. You know, it was about sex and drugs and rock and roll, but from a different perspective. And therefore, yeah, I moved to Paris and... okay, let's have a first break, and I show you now. I'm going to show you a video about me in Paris performing a Velvet Underground song. It was in a very fancy place in the fancy years, and I'll tell you more about that. But I was in the Paris. I don't know if some of you remember that fancy club. It was fancy, you know. And everything is fancy when you have to deal with France and rock and roll. You end up in a fancy, you know. Trap. Donc ça, c'était en fait des soirées. C'est Nicolas Hulman. Je ne sais pas si on va vous parler de Nicolas Hulman. Il organisait des soirées avec un groupe. Et en fait, c'était un peu le karaoké. Karaoké avec un vrai groupe rock. Et là, les musiciens, je crois que c'était Dub Boys. En référence à la chanson de hip-hop. Et là, je m'étais retrouvé là le texte qui dit Barbara Danger, Evie Danger, tout ça. Et c'était à l'époque, il y avait une de mes secretaries. L'époque où on était considéré comme fille. Et Carolina Bomba, c'est elle qui a filmé. Après, j'ai fait un espèce de montage. Un carton blanc comme ça, c'est les astuces de montage, c'est ça. Je savais pas qui je voulais être, j'arrivais pas à être Covid, alors du coup j'ai essayé d'être Nico, mais j'arrivais pas à être. Ah ben on voit par là, là c'est la petite. C'est un chanteur qui est venu à une époque, maintenant c'est Axel Bauer, il est là comme ça. Mais alors, c'était quand on pouvait fumer, tout ça. Bon, il n'y avait pas de masque, on fumait. Là, là. Une boîte de une boîte à on revient j'ai créé une boîte de prod Cork and Paper Corp. Non mais bon, mais en tout cas oui c'était voilà de beaux souvenirs. Le Velvet Underground aussi m'a permis de rencontrer plein de gens fantastiques, hein, dont toi, et voilà. Mais bon, en tout cas très bien. Ouais, c'est intéressant, ça fait comme dans les bonus des DVD. It's just like in a DVD, sorry, it was mostly in French because it's, you know, it had to deal with very personal things, you know. But let's switch back to English, basically. So let's move on. What time is it? It's already 10. No, it's not 10. It's 9. Great. It's going well. So, what are the songs? Oh, let us see if someone asks a question on the chat. Good evening. What the? J'adore, bravo. Je vous laisse avec regret. Ok, bon, ben au revoir. Sorry, yes. Sylvia. Oh, Sylvia, oui, je connais bien Sylvia. Mais écoute, merci en tout cas. Merci de. Thanks, thank you for coming. She played in the casting, remember? She was part of the casting. She was the one when.
Sylvia. I don't think
shall we go for that song? A beautiful song, Sylvia. There is a beautiful song on called Sylvia from the Blue Mask, one of the best albums. It was one of my first. After I discovered the Velvet Underground, and I moved on to Lou Reed, and the Blue Mask was well. And I thought, wow, that sounds really good. And then I really like Street Hassles as well. Yeah. Just fantastic. Berlin, amazing. Of course. Yeah, I think most of them in the 70s, apart from two or three, and I'd still have to go for the 80s because it's a bit
and
hard.
And even in this two or three, there's always a song you have to save, you have to
definitely keep. yeah even in the album from the 80s, I mean the late
in the like 70s, in the 80s,
in the 80s,
yeah. I'm not that sure I don't think you can
save. Sylvia is back, look
mysterious.
It's great, thank you Sylvia. And okay, let's move on now to let's keep on daring. That's what it's all about. That's what rock and roll is all about, you know. And alors, you talked about John Cale.
Yeah,
that's a good thing because he's a good chap. John Cale is good. I really like most of what he did solo. You know, also in the 80s it was really strange, but it was different than Lou Reed because he was. You know, well, but back in the 90s, he, you know, became very, very, I think, very good looking Welsh man. Very, very nice. I love his work. And there is a beautiful Velvet Underground song that he sung on the White Light, White Heat.
Shall we go for that? So yeah, take my violin. Yeah.
Okay.
let's destroy.
Can I just have the lyrics?
Yeah, definitely.
Please.
Yeah.
Because maybe it's the only one I don't know.
You don't know by heart.
I don't know by heart. Good, we can say that in English, by
heart. Yeah, by heart. I know things by heart. Okay. Which is great. You know, it's a good occasion to learn as well. Tonight, there aren't any tarot readings, but we learn together. We are together. We are the world. We are here for the people of the future. Hang on, let us try not to... Okay, to interfere with each other. Yeah. Okay, you follow your path, okay. and I'll follow mine.
Okay, let's go.
Go for it, mate.
Lady Godiva, he dressed so demurely. Pats the head of another curly hair boy. Just another toy. Sick with silence, she weeps sincerely, saying words that have also clearly been said so long ago. Wrapped gently round her shoulder, life has made her that much bolder now that she's found out how. Dressed in silk, Latin lace and envy, pride and joy of the latest Benny Fair, pretty passing care. Hair today, now dipped in the water, making love to every poor daughter's son. Isn't it fun? Now today, probing grace and envy, Lady Godiva appears to see if anyone's there and hasn't a care.
The turn is coming, the nothing's
greatly
turning on the machines that
neatly pump out the body lies bare. Shade and hellness, what once was screaming,
now
turning on the machine
and almost sleeping.
Pump the body lies bare. Strapped securely to the white table, in the coast, the body to wither and rise, underneath the white light. Doctor arrives with knife and baggage, see the growth has just so much cabbage, that must now be cut away. Now come the moment of great, great decision. The doctor is making his first incision. One goes here, one goes there. Hear the tubes leaking, say someone who's sloppy. The patient, it seems, is not so well sleeping.
Screams echo up the wall.
Don't panic, someone give him Bentayto and Stanley. Doctor removes
is play casually slow from the brain. At my kind of ten, his head won't move.
Right. This is a very dreadful story about someone who wakes up in the midst of an operation, which is something, I don't know if it ever happened to you, I wish it never happened to you, but it's very dreadful. So I like the way the song itself, the way it's written, and you know, the emotion that is conveyed, you know, in the whole structure. And I think we did a good job, you know, doing that. This is a violin, you know, I wanted to play because I'm that kind of person, not only who I mean, I want things, you know, I dare, I want, and I'm not silent, not yet. And I know a few things, also it's about the four things, you know, the four main things, you know. And then, yes, I wanted to have a violin, and then my grandfather bought me a violin, and then I started to study violin because thanks to John Cale, because of John Cale. And it's a great instrument because it seems to be, it looks like the shape of a human soul, utterly, you know, it needs a lot of control, and if it's controlled, it's boring, and if it's devoid of control, it can be dangerously boring. I don't know. I have a bit of gypsy origins. You know, I have gypsy origins. Okay, I realized, okay. You know, when I played during this performance, I realized that I had gypsy origins. So, great. So, yes. Well, beautiful thing. So, John Cale, yeah, you mentioned him. So what did you have a few words to say? Because you did some podcast shows.
Yeah.
Can you give us more information about that?
It's called Graines de Violence. And the last one I did, it's a show where I talk about musicians I love. And it lasts like an hour in general. And I did one about John Cale, and also one about Nico.
Nico, definitely.
If you want to go there, you can find it on Mixcloud.
I'll Mixcloud, and I put the links once the show is over. I'll put the links in the description of the video. Va bene? And great, yeah, I advise you to have an ear, to jeter une oreille, to listen to those podcasts. It's really interesting, and you have a selection. You put a selection of songs that you like, and you talk about the whole concept, context, I mean, and yes, and the concept of the Velvet Underground. You know, there's always a way to, you know, I know how to put this on it, but yeah, sort of. And yes, John Cale. Yeah, John Cale. I think. Yeah,
I especially love his discography. His discography, yeah. Because it's very rich, and it's very different from album to album.
Definitely.
I'm a huge fan of Paris 1919. I think
yes, it was of his most popular. I mean, it is known that it is his Berlin. You know, Lou Reed has Berlin, and
well,
John Cale. They are very different.
Berlin is a very dark and
and
a depressing album. Paris 1919 is not a joyful album. It talks about terrible things.
Definitely.
But it's done in a very classy and elegant way.
Yeah,
it's the kind, you know, when someone talks about his sadness, but he doesn't cry.
It's
just tells it like it is with beautiful words, simply put, but very efficient.
Tout à fait. And it's a barocco. It's very barocco.
Yeah.
It's like you know, like it sounds a bit sometimes like the Beach Boys. He was a big Brian Wilson fan, and he has a song
He's
named
a
after,
song, yeah.
Which is beautiful.
I believe you, Mr. Wilson. I believe you anyway.
It's fun because nowadays there's so many current singers, they try, no, I don't do it properly, but they try to reach that, but he just did it, you know. He was a member of the Velvet Underground. Velvet Underground, you know, they get famous, why? Because there was Andy Warhol came and thought, okay, he worked on the notion of decadence. He was just a profeta. So in Italiano, of decadence, and he just found like one band that he saw and thought, okay, they're decadent, just because they are playing too loud and they are, you know, etc. And yes, and they didn't really care about things, the velvet on the ground, and then they got into that hip that made them important in history. And they were also good writers, good journalists, and you had this this prophet of this destruction of modern times, which is Andy Warhol. You know, you had where we are now is also thanks to Warhol. You know, it's he's not guilty for having created all that thing. You know, that YouTube thing and those 15 minutes of fame and all this vanity, cette vanité profonde. But he just knew it was going to happen. It's just like that guy, like Albert Einstein, and you know, the atomic bomb was created not because of him, but he was a bit, you know, responsible for that. So that's the same for Warhol.
But he didn't mean it.
You know, and he did a great cover art that you hold on your T-shirt. So do we have T-shirts to sell? No. What we have actually to sell, we have something interesting to sell before we move on to another live song. You know, well, Well, it's just difficult with those shades. You know, the early name of the Velvet Underground, when they got together, Lou Reed and John Cale. If you want to know the precise story, just have a look on the internet, on Wikipedia or something. No, we're not here. There are many, many people on YouTube who tell stories and copy-paste and all that. No, we don't do that. But when they first met, they had a band called the Shades. And so other writers said, the Jades. We'll never know. We don't care. That's why we wear shades anyway. Oh, no. So yes, apropos what we have to sell, apropos money, where the heck is that? Tac, oh, la 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 la. Here we are. Yes, if you will, don't feel like you have to, but you can put some money in the jar tip via le PayPal compte de moi, so you have the address. All the funds. You know, you can put what you want. You don't have to, but if you want to, you can. All the funds will directly go to the Association of the Victims of the Velvet Underground. That is very serious. I'm talking serious.
Sorry.
It's just that many musicians suffered with it. It's a fantastic band, but because of that band, many musicians just missed their real targets. I think of people like Rudolf Burger. I think of bands such as the Limanas, you know. Limanas. Those people, they need to, you know, they need some help. They need, therefore, a bit of money given with the heart. No, maybe they have plenty of money, but they need money given from the heart to their heart to get rid of all the, you know, just to get real, you know. And we need also a bit of that money. We'll share between those people and us.
Of course.
You know, well, we. So don't hesitate. Usually I don't do that. I don't give money to people on the net. I don't do that. I wouldn't give money to, you know, to an online show. What the, you know, just pointless.
Hell, you know?
I only give money. There's only, you know, I only give money to Per Ubu. And I advise you to have a look at DPK TV. Perubu, I'll provide the links later on. But yes, Perubu is the very last band that means something. The band exists, and they provide. If you just, it's just $5 a month, and you can access live performance. You can talk and ask questions, and you have David Thomas, the fantastic David Thomas. And it's great, you know, the music stopped, and we're talking about serious things now. But it's true, it's the last band. I only buy records by Perubu. I only give my money to Perubu. I got merch hypnotized. So I provide the links. If you like Perubu, I advise you strongly to register to that. It's on Patreon. It's a sort of online software, I don't know, to to give money. You become patron of artists. It's just silly. But I do that, and I like that. And apropos, we're talking about serious things. Baribou is very serious, and I would like to say hello to Christy, the manager of Communex. So okay, and yes, apropos Baribou, let us listen to. Let's have another break and let's listen to the first guitarist from Perubu. He was a member of Rocket from the Tombs. And then when Rocket from the Tombs separated, he went with David Thomas with Perubu, and he died before the release of the first album. But he was a big Velvet Underground fan, and he played some Velvet Underground songs. So let us listen to Peter Lofner. Doesn't work, so I have to use my bloody phone. That OBS is free, it's cool, but sometimes it's like. So let's listen to What Goes On by Peter Lofner. It was recorded. Yeah, it's a bit cloudy, sorry. It's smoky, smoky mood. It's called... let us wait. Go for it. It's one of the most beautiful songs he wrote in the early 70s.
It was 7 o'clock in the morning, too late to handle the day. At home it was only 2:30, the skin on my wrist turning gray. Stood up, wished us good luck, he changed his attitude twice. The box in the corner shivered in fear, he was tired and hungry for days. Back home he bought a new stomach from Liverpool, made in Detroit. Constantly passing on matches, my old man and his gun. Who did, Gallagher did, the same old thing every time. Gave up, more empty cup, he was tired and hungry for days. Life a little easier to have Holland on the run. It didn't make life long to forget her, my old man and his gun. Rushed out, lions about, wasting away on advice. 103, 400 and more, I haunt you for the rest of your life.
The Ghost Story, one of the most beautiful, don't break your guitar, you don't deserve it. Beautiful, just beautiful. You can clap yourself, because we don't expect anything from the outside world.
I prefer, you know, nobody clap, then I'm the only one who claps.
No, don't you worry, it's just great. Beautiful song. I wish I had sung it, gosh. Anyway. Well, yeah, John Kay left, and then the Velvet move on to more quiet little songs, but also to some very, very, very beautiful songs. And up, so you can see I have a mouse. Up, you can see I have a light on top of my toit. Anyway, let's move on then. Okay, let's play together. We haven't tried
okay.
Before.
Yeah.
Together with two guitars.
Okay.
So... I'll tell you something. I think that song is very beautiful because we enter into, as John Kay left, someone came to replace him. It's Doug Yule. And Doug Yule actually is really cool. I really like that guy. I really like his voice. I think he would deserve more credits about in the story of the Velvet Underground.
I agree.
He did his best. It was not easy to deal with people like Lou Reed and Sesnick and that kind of people, and he did his best, and he was a great musician and great singer. And I have to say hello to Doug Yule, who now crafts, I'll tell you what, maybe you don't know that, but he crafts violins.
Oh,
yes,
really?
The one who plays John Cale, who used to play viola and all that stuff, he crafts also violas
this
and
so
cellos
sweet.
And all that.
Okay.
And yes, Doug, if you can hear that, I don't know, by chance, well, I have things to ask you. I have something to ask you, something. Yeah, we'll talk about that a bit later on in the show. Doug, let's make this beautiful song, which is like a prayer. It's called Jesus. And yes, I keep the, if you don't mind, I keep the, yeah, it's beautiful.
The Doug Yule picture.
Like Yeah, I kept the picture.
Of course, I love
so that we're three of the yeah. sort of trinity.
Okay.
It's a beautiful song. Let us try not to screw it. Thank you, Jesus. Yeah. Yeah, sometimes we're falling out of grace. And sometimes we try so hard to do the right things and to play the right play and the right notes. And sometimes you just miss up. But the Spirit of Jesus Christ is here to forgive us. And therefore, if the heart of Jesus forgives you, you are utterly forgiven. And it's okay. Just great. Thank you, Doug. Thank you, Doug. I know that some of you think, well, Doug, you know, he released the fifth album by the Velvet Underground, Squeeze. I don't know if I have the picture here. Do you have the Squeeze? No, I don't have it. But you know that album?
Not that bad.
It's not, yeah. I would say it's a great album because Doug, you was a great musician and still is a great person. And there are songs actually that could challenge some many songs on Loaded, you know. And to me, Squeeze is the fifth Velvet Underground album. And the Velvet Underground, even though on that record he was the only one to play along with the drummer Ian Pace or something, it carried the best he could the spirit of the Velvet Underground. And yes, the spirit does not belong to Lou Reed or John Cale or Maureen Tucker or whoever. The spirit It's just like the power of Christ. You know, we sang about Jesus who can forgive all the, you know, when you screw a song, Jesus, you know, forgives you. And the velvet, the spirit of the velvet on the ground, it, you know, it's something that can, it's just not about personalities. That's what I believe, and that's what I actually, I'm preparing something about that. I'll let you know a bit later on. Maybe you know, but yes, and I would like to sing a song from that Squeeze album. Yes, yes, you might think you might think what you will, but I sing a song. One of my favorite from this album is called Friends. Just as simple as that. And yes, it's called Friends.
Yeah.
It's called Friends. Let's do it. Let's do it. Do you know the chorus? Do you know the chorus? No, you
didn't. The chorus.
Maybe you can try.
I know the beginning. How can I tell her? I remember this, but I don't remember enough.
Okay. Let's see.
To sing it. This is a live show.
This is a live show.
For a reminder.
And you know what, Doug, you're great.
Yeah.
But
now we can.
What the heck is going on?
Doug Gill is actually singing this one.
Doug, I put you just under the banana.
It's very hard to film you with this.
How can I tell her? What can I say? We've been friends for so long. Never knew it could go wrong. When I look at her, words just won't come. Though I try to write them, fine, I couldn't recite them. And the dawn comes running to my room. And the time for telling is coming soon. Ah, she's a believer. That's what she said. When I looked in her eyes, all I see is goodbye. And the dawn comes running to my room, and the time for telling is coming soon. Oh, how can I tell her? What can I say? We've been friends for so long. Never knew it could go wrong. Friends for so long. For so long. For so long. For so long. Petite chanson dédiée à tous les amis. Dedicate a beautiful song dedicated to all friends. You know, sometimes friends can end up, you know, in a strange way. But it's because I think that, you know, when he was writing this song, he was not thinking about mere friendship. I don't know. I can say it.
It's too bad.
I don't know
it better, because I would have loved to make choirs on this one. It's
well,
very very beautiful song.
Next
and to
time.
Be honest. I've listened to Squeeze. I've never listened to Squeeze before I met you. and you made me listen.
I'm glad.
It's a pretty good one. You know, it's
rather good. Despising really
it freely, but it's a good one.
Dirk says that he regrets because he said he was manipulated by the manager, Steve Sesnick, I guess.
And he's not a very good man.
He's a manager, you know. Yeah, well, he just did his job, you know. It's like Tony DeFries for Bowie.
John Cage said he was a snake. Yeah.
You know, but without him and without Warhol, you know, the Velvet Underground wouldn't have, you know, we wouldn't be here. You know, so we have to thank those rotten apples.
Thank you, Sesnick, I guess.
You know, those pieces of shit, we have to thank them because they create the ground where we can walk, you know. Take it easy, it's going to be fine. Okay. Don't worry, mate.
I told you I'm a cougher.
Good.
I cough.
And yes, friends, many friends. So let us have another, well, multimedia break and let us watch a video. It's still Velvet Underground cover. I did with my very good friend Stefan Bo, with whom I, you know, together we are the Small Assassins. And for those who are interested, we have some very big, exciting news going along. There will be a massive collection of new songs, and yes, you know, Stefan. You know, he's a great composer. He's a genius. And when you meet a genius, you just have to you bow to it. You just have to, you would just enjoy that. So he did most of the he did like the whole thing. And it's about to be released in a form or another. It's a new album. It's going to be double. It's just going to be great. You know, I played some instruments on that, but you know, he managed to produce it very, very well. And well. And this is Stefan, with whom I play Discover of Heroin. Let's go for that, and let's have a little upper. It was in Paris. You know, we're French, huh? In case you haven't noticed, we're French. Okay, here we are. We talk about Velvet Underground. I take my silly accent from God knows where, and I play rock music. I screw my souls and all that. Yes, I'm French. You know, that's the way things are. You know, we lost many wars. You know, we lost a lot of wars, but we're still here. I'm not even French, I tell you. You know, I was born in France.
We're still proud. Okay.
You know, but we're here, and that's it. C'est le grand guignol, in a way. But we won't hurt you. So let's go for a hero in 1, 2, 3, 4.
Les Français, au cœur exilé. Oh. Oh. Vous savez, quand on est artiste. Non, vous savez pas. Pas grave.
Yeah.
Back in time, sorry for that, sorry, we were like, we just, I just went back, you know, in the living room and there is this delay, and I was like, okay, yeah, there are a few like 30 seconds left, and actually no, so I hope we haven't lost. Hey Duke, what the heck are you doing here? Okay, so now it's time. What the heck is time? Where are we now?
I think it's...
Well, it's going to be your turn, so I would like before. Do you have a tourne disque? Do you have a manche disque, a tourne disque?
I don't have one.
You don't have? Do you have a records vinyls, because it's very fashionable nowadays? Vinyls.
Yeah,
you have vinyls, vinyls.
I'm pretty ashamed to say no. I don't have one. I listen to music like a pig.
You don't own a damn vinyl disc?
No, I don't.
You don't?
I don't, because so I have such a small apartment and I have such a huge collection of CDs and I don't want to.
If I offer you your very first, this is a very first. This is for Velvet Underground fans. Now they're going to be like, well, what the heck is that? I have it. It's a bootleg pirate and there's a mask. No pun intended.
Okay,
it's called Take Off Your Mask, and it's labeled, I'll show you, it's yours, but I'll show you later on. It's labeled both as at, or whatever, Lou Reed and John Cale. But,
this is
actually, look at that, yeah, I'm going, no, but c'est bon, déjà là avec l'heure, oh là là, on est ultra en retard. Look at that, it's
up, and it's labeled, you know, because they do that when they create bootlegs like that. They need to remove the real names sometimes on the disc when they press it. When they press it, they put a silly name. And here you have Dear Owl, which is lurid reverse, and you have silly names like
This is amazing.
First Time, What Did You Hurt Me, Narcos Part 1. On the other side is the same with titles like Hope You'll Get It, All the Best to You, Narcos Part 2. And actually on one side you have Lurid Live in 75 or something.
Okay,
and on the other side, John Cale Live.
This is amazing. I'm gonna buy it. I'm gonna buy
it. The sound is shitty. You know, it's really shitty.
I'm gonna buy one
and
anyway.
It's more or less, moreover, it's vinyl, therefore it's double. It's really shitty, but
and the title is just voilà. Freaking perfect.
It's written. Take off your mask.
Thank you so much.
I don't know. No, you know. Then you do what you freaking will, guys, bros.
Thank you so much.
Great. So, oh gosh, I feel like I'm getting inhabited by something. Something. You know. Some of you may know. Certains d'entre vous savent en France que. Je suis le canal officiel de l'esprit de David Bowie. Voilà. Alors, je sais qu'il y en a beaucoup qui prétendent, qui disent qu'ils sont le canal de Bowie, tout ça, que c'est très courant. Ça, depuis la mort de Bowie, il y a eu effectivement. Since Bowie died, many people in France pretend to be the channel, to channel the spirit of David Bowie. And I do, but the difference is, well, one guy said, hey, what the heck are you saying? What about that? And I said, I know, because Bowie told me. And indeed, Bowie speaks to me. David Bowie, yes. David Bowie speaks to me. It's thanks to Bowie I discovered the Velvet Underground. You know, no, it's thanks to that girl I love. No, yeah. I rewrite history, never mind. but there's a link, obvious. And indeed, yes, David Bowie discovered the Velvet Underground. Apparently it was in 1970, and he went to a show, and then he spoke to Lou Reed, and later on one guy said, hey, but Lou Reed just left the band. You spoke with Doug Yule. He just played a joke on you. And Bowie was like, oh, wow, I'm so stupid. I'm so British. Oh. And anyway, then he met Lou Reed in 72. I mean, in 72, he produced along with Mick Ronson, who was the David Bowie's guitarist at the time. And great. He was making the arrangement. He was making arrangements and all that. He was a great musician. And he produced, I mean, most of the production is due to Mick Ronson, but Bowie was the name at the time. Bowie was into his magical things because Bowie is magical, and Bowie lives on through me. So no bite. The spirit of David Bowie is speaking right now, and I love the Velvet Underground. I think the Velvet Underground. Oh gosh, Bowie speaking is so it hurts me so bad. The Velvet Underground were more important than the Beatles for modern music, actually. Because if you listen closely to modern music, it's more about rather than Penny Lane. And yes, the Velvet Underground is great. Just like the Pixies. I love the Pixies. I think they're great.
Of course. Yeah.
So Lou was a very dear friend of mine. I think what I like in the Velvet Underground. Yes, but I prefer John Cale. I think he was the nasty part, the more dangerous. He was much more fragmented than Lou Reed. So you have a question for David Bowie? Yeah.
Right.
Yes.
Now?
Yes. Yeah. He's here.
So, how does it look around you right now?
It's just great. I think I love Joseph, love his shows, and it's great. I watch it from heaven. You're in heaven. Yes, look up here. I'm in heaven, mate. I've got scores to come be seen. David Bowie, I have a question for you. Why do you have such a silly accent? Because I like to make fun of myself, and because I have a sense of humor, which is sometimes, which is not the case for many of my fans. French fans, obviously. And j'ai demandé, sorry for the guy, j'ai demandé pour les amis français, des fois qu'ils comprennent pas trop. J'ai dit, pourquoi Bowie, pourquoi tu prends un accent à la con comme ça? Et il me dit, bah, parce que j'ai le sens de l'autodérision. Voilà, contrairement à beaucoup de mes fans français. Voilà. Et bon, non. Il a de l'humour. Il a de l'humour et il est, comment dire, c'est... He lives on. His soul is so great. Oh, je ne sais plus qui parle, en fait. I just don't know where I am.
This is impressive.
Comment c'est? How is it, David? David, I'm going to ask him, how is it in heaven? What do you hear?
There's no music here, just stream of sounds. And live stream from Joseph, Les Compulsions Monologiques.
You are great, thank you, David. I think he's just great.
He still has it, he still has it.
Yes, he'll never change, basically. Thank you, David. Well, we were supposed to sing that song, you know, well, before you sing that song from Transformer, let's go, because the spirit of David Bowie is still with us. Okay. There is a great David Bowie song he wrote as a tribute to the Velvet Underground. It's called Queen Beach on his Hunky Dory album. Go for it, Benji!
I'm up on the 11th floor and I'm watching the cruises below. She's down on the street and she tries hard to pull Sister Flo. All my heart's in the basement and my weekend's in no time low. Cause she's hoping to score so I can see her letting go. Walk out of her heart, walk out of her mind. Oh, not her. She's so swishy in a satin sack, in a flat coat, a piggly bobbity hat. Oh, God, I could be better than that. Of sweet talking nights, walking games. And she's known in the darkest club for pushing the heads of the dames. If she said she can do it, then she can do it. She don't make false claims. Oh, she's a queen, such a queen that your laughter is sucked in her brain. Now she's leading him on, and he's laying right down. What didn't I say?
No. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Oh, she's so
in the satin and sat in a front coat, a peabody bobbity hat. Oh, that I could be better than that.
So I lay down the while and I gaze at my hotel wall. Oh, the court is so cold, it don't feel like no bed at all, no bed at all. Yeah, I lay down a while and I look at my hotel wall. And he is down on the street, so I throw both his bags down the hall. And I'm phoning a cab, cause my stomach feels full. There's a taste in my mouth, and it's no taste at all. Cause it could have been me, yes, it could have been me. What didn't I say? What didn't I say?
I know, yo, she's so
switching in a satin and sat in a frock coat, a peabody bobbity hat. Oh, God, I could be better than that.
Better.
Oh, yeah. All right, now. No, 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 no. Oh, you can bitch down, 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 down.
So all of a sudden I got inhabited by the spirit of Lou Reed. No, 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 no. Oh, sorry, gosh. My heart is open. My heart is open. It's like a wound of, you know, but we don't know each other very well, but you now maybe you understand me a bit better, but, you know, I'm le cœur sacré est ouvert. C'est une cathédrale ouverte en ruine, en lumière. It's so hot to deal with that, and therefore many spirits enter it, and then they grab my soul. So there is David Bowie, there's Lou Reed, there's, you know, just that's the way things are. So, well, thank you. That's, you know, well, thank you, David. See you soon. You know, I hear him so soon. He's with me, inside of me. En moi, pour moi, en moi, en vous, en moi. So, well, Ali, go for it. Another song from the Transformer album. It's called, the funny song is about our prophet of apocalypse, Andy Warhol. Looks a scream hanging on my wall. Okay, and I try to, you know, I quite like to hold camera because I'm a film director, Arjun, I'm a film director.
I know that.
You know, I'm not only a, you know, a spirit drifter and the channel, whatever. Oh, gosh. Quand tu veux.
Okay.
Let's go for that.
I was sleeping gently, napping when I heard the phone. Who is on the other end talking? Am I even home? Did you see what she did to him? Did you hear what they said? Just a New York conversation rattling in my head. Oh my, and what shall we wear? Oh my, and who really cares? Just a New York conversation, gossip all the time. Did you hear who did what to who? Happens all the time. Who must touch them? Who must have him here in the city of shows? Opening, closing, bad report, everybody knows. Oh, outside, and what shall we call? Oh, I'm glad to hear from you all. I am calling, yes, I'm calling, just to speak to you. All I know this night will kill me if I can't be with you. If I can't be with you.
Such a cute song. It's so beautiful. It reminds me a bit of If You Close the Door, After Hours.
Exactly.
Just the same feeling, as if it's like the same characters. C'est comme si c'était les mêmes personnages. Je crois que l'audience française, ça fait un moment qu'elle a lâché. Mais c'est pas grave. Oh, en même temps, tout le monde parle anglais, hein. We all speak English, don't we? Comment?
Je dis bonjour aux copains français.
Ben oui, voilà. J'espère que.
Ils sont peut-être partis là, mais bonjour à eux quand même.
Donc c'était ton premier cadeau. Voilà, I offered you the first present. That's done so many things to give and little time, you know, such a little time. Okay, allez, let's move on. Let's go back to John Cale. Hop. Attends, ouais, non, on va faire ça. Hop, voilà. Here we are. And
still velvet.
Yeah, let's go back to the Velvet Underground. And there is this beautiful song. John Cale still plays that live. Very often he opens his shows with that song, you know. And this is very beautiful, typical song. And on the original demo, you can find those demos on the Velvet Underground box set. This one, you have demos, and it was sung by John Cale. So... Yes, I'm going to sing it a bit like a la John Cale, hein, comme on dit chez nous, hein. Hop, t'as vu de nouveau, il y a le petit souci en fait. Je sais pas pourquoi, à chaque fois qu'on appuie là comme ça. See something we have to deal with that. Shiny, shiny boots of leather. We blush, girl child in the dark. Comes in bells, your servant don't forsake him. Strike the mistress and cure his heart. Scenes of street-like fancies, chase the costumes she shall wear. Ermine furs adorn the imperious. Severin awaits you there. I am tired and I am weary. I could sleep for a thousand years. A thousand dreams that would awake me. Different colors,
made of tears.
Kiss the boot of shiny, shiny leather, shiny, shiny leather in the dark. Tongue of thongs, the belt that does await you. Strike the mistress and cure his heart. Severin, Severin speaks so slightly. Severin, down on your bended knee. Taste the whip and Lord, not given lightly. Taste the whip now, plead for me. I am tired and I am weary. I could sleep for a thousand years, a thousand dreams that would awake me. Different colors made of tears. Shiny, shiny boots of leather, whiplash girl child in the dark. Comes in bells, your servant, don't forsake him. Strike him, mistress, and cure his heart.
Beautiful wow. Song, great. Qui est basé sur la nouvelle, je crois, de... C'est les raisins de la colère, c'est ça. It's based upon... I was just joking, kidding. No, it's based upon that book.
I love
it's based
there's
upon
a,
book.
There's a line I love. Is
which one? Which one?
Taste the whip in love not given lightly.
Yes, yeah, that's what would deserve any women, actually. I don't know. I'm kidding. Oh, don't take. Oh, come on. You know, I'm kidding. Great, great, great. Let's keep on. On a un bon rythme. Right. Your turn now to sing. Alors, this is an actual song by John Cale, one of his best. Ah, oh, we don't. And it's one of his strange album from one of his strange albums from the 80s. It's Caribbean Sunset.
Not the greatest one.
No, it's not Caribbean Sunset. My mistake.
No, it's Artificial Intelligence.
Definitely, yeah. The year after, 1985. And there is that song that just rocks. Okay, I mean, it's just
it's a
beautiful.
Redemption song.
Definitely.
Chasing ghosts, and I don't like it. I wish someone would show me where to draw the line. I laid down the sword, if you can take it, and tell everyone back home I'm doing fine. I was with you down in Acapulco, trading clothing for some wine, smelling like an old Adobe woman. Are we in Baroth, plaguing for lost time? And I was thinking mother, I was thinking about what's mine. I was living my life like a Hollywood, and I was dying on the vine.
troops, the celebration in the sun. The authority said my paper were all in order, and if I wasn't such a coward, I would run. Meet me where the shooting's over. Meet me on the other part of town. Yes, you can bring your friends along for protection. It's always nice to have them hanging around. And I was thinking about my mother. I was thinking about what's mine. I was living my life like a Hollywood, and I was dying, dying on the vine.
J'aurais pu continuer comme ça encore pendant. Bon.
J'essaie de garder le rythme.
Beautiful, because the lyrics from that song, I think he written he, at that time he was working with a writer, a certain writer. I can't remember the name. But apparently, I'm not sure if the lyrics are from Lou Reed. So we are waiting for the strange Lou Reed. I mean John Cale. Sorry
okay. That.
What the fuck am I saying? What the beep am I saying? Yeah, but he was from Coleman or something. I think the lyrics are from a poet called Coleman. The whole album,
oh, really?
It seems to me. We have
never
to check
heard
on
about
Wikipedia.
That. It's very strange.
But it's just beautiful song. You know,
yeah.
No matter who wrote it, what the yeah, it's
I
just
thought
beautiful.
It was I really was sure it was his one because it actually a very personal one. He had just stopped drugs and alcohol. He just
I mean, he made that song his own. I mean, it's his song because it's on his album. But the lyricist is, it seems to me. We'll see. We don't want to talk about certainties. I don't want knowledge. I don't want certainties. That was that philosopher Rupert Madden.
In fact, I wrote it.
You did it. Great. I think I found a very nice point of view. Look at that. Seems, wow. Gosh, and there is the light. I'm beginning to see the light. I won't tell you why I'm beginning. Oh, rainbow. There's a rainbow on my. Leon, est-ce que tu vois? Yeah, the rainbow.
He's a
I talk to
maker.
My son.
He's a real filmmaker.
Look at that. It's like. I could do more than film. I could become a millionaire with all that crap. Let's move on to something. Okay, we pay tribute to Doug Hill, we pay tribute to Lou Reed, John Cale, and now it's time.
Who's left?
Well, I guess the Maureen Tucker. Maureen Tucker, we spoke about her. I think she's great. She released a bunch of beautiful albums. Notably, I don't know if we can say that, this beautiful record from 1990, gosh, I'm growing old, I can't remember the years, 1991. What the fuck?
1994, I guess.
Three or four? Because I think it was before the Velvet Underground reunite, like for this you know, to open for you two, for Christ's sake.
Okay, I'm not sure.
I used to know that by heart. It's supposed to be written on the. What's the point of having those big sleeves if you can't even find the year? That's the most important thing for a record, the year. 1991. Okay, I found it.
So you were right the first time. Calm down. It's okay.
Yeah. So it's a beautiful record, and there are many guests, including, of course, the members of the original Velvet Underground. You can't find Doug Yule. Too bad. Too bad for her. And there is, it's, well, as I said, beautiful. I spent a week there the other night. I think Motaka, a lot of people are bashing Motaka because apparently she tried to express her political opinions
And well, we all have political opinions, and you know, people. I think, you know, people when they're over 70, they don't know how to use properly the all those, you know, all the stupid things, the social media, social networks, and all that. So let us not blame her for thinking what she thinks. You know, I think I thought about that. It was the same when the president of the United States was elected, the current one. There was Joey Santiago from the Pixies, and he spent his day bashing that guy. You know, it was like, gosh, you're this guitar player from the Pixies. Well, bashing him, it's just not revolutionary compared to what you are. And it's just like, don't follow people on Facebook. Well, best would be to forget about that Facebook, but don't follow famous people on Facebook, because you realize they're just normal people, but they have the right to be normal people. They have the right to think, to be wrong, so, according to your views. So Mo, we love you, Mo. You're just great. And you are the drummer of the Velvet Underground, and that's it.
We don't care about your opinions, Mo.
We don't care, and people shouldn't care. And stop bashing Mo because of her silly opinions. You have silly opinions as well. We all have silly opinions. I won't talk about mine, otherwise. Oh, you know. No, I have silly opinions. You know what I believe in? I think all women should vote for one woman, and all men should vote for a man. And there should be a presidential couple. That's what I believe in. But try to explain to them. This is le bon sens incarné, avoir un couple présidentiel. That would be the solution. Que les femmes, parce qu'à un moment, je me suis dit, ah, peut-être, maybe women should vote for men and men for women to create this couple. But no, I think women for women for a woman and men for men. Man for men. Men for man. For Christ's sake. That would be a great idea. Maybe people from the future, they'll hear that and say he was absolutely right.
I would vote for you, actually.
Alors, voilà. But then I would need to have a president, a woman as well. And then le couple cosmique, well, that would be the future of democracy, to have a couple. Okay? So stop bashing Mo. She was beautiful. She still is beautiful, of course. So I'm going to sing a song called I'm Not. And on that song, it's written on it, I'm Not, it's in disorder. And you have John Cale, Lou, Mo, obviously, Sterling, along with Victor and Sonny and all the musicians. But you have the Velvet Underground before they reunited. Before they reunited.
It's a great record.
Just great.
Discovered because of you.
Thanks to me.
Thanks.
Oops,
to you.
Sorry. Spitting of joy. Spit of joy. And yes, bon, voilà, je fais la promo. Hein. Je fais la promo de Père Ubu, de Motoker, de. Voilà, je suis comme ça. Je passe des contrats avec les gens. Tu sais, Facebook, ça sert à ça. Hein. You meet people and you know, you speak about them and you help them and maybe you'll get something. But I'm not expecting anything from anyone. I'm not expecting anything. I'm not. Comment on fait? Je remets mes... Non, allez, j'enlève mes glasses. Bro. Is it with my mysterious noise maker? Bah, ah non, on voit, ouais, non, en fait, non. C'est un micro-corg, voilà. C'est pas très sérieux, va bien. Alors là, tu peux l'utiliser du coup parce que là, voilà. Just fooling around, my feet in the stars, my head on the ground. I'm not doing very much, flopping on the couch. I'm not getting anywhere, way around the house. Another day is running by,
and I'm still sitting here. I used to have a decade. Now it's just a year. I'm not thinking very fair, staring at the tea. I don't think I'm gonna last if it's all I do. I need a junk stop, stop sleeping on my walk. I think I'm slowly draining, but the wafters whizzily. I'm not fooling anyone, maybe just myself. 'Cause I'm not have any fun sitting on a shelf. Another day is running by, and it should getting here. I used to have a decade. Now it's just a year.
Well, it sounds a bit like a Nico song.
Yeah.
I played it a la Nico. Yeah. So, sorry, Mo. Sorry, Mo, I played it a la Nico. So it's very
interesting. They were not best friends, if I remember well.
I think they just couldn't understand each other. They were just on two separate levels.
Yeah.
They there is one joke one day. They were together with John Cale, Reed, and Sterling, and all the band. And they were like, well, Andy Warhol, John Cale was like saying, I'm going to try to imitate John Cale.
Welsh accent.
Gosh, how to do that? Well. I don't know. Well, Andy Warhol. Well, no, I just don't know how to do that. Sorry. I can challenge Spirit of Bowie. I can't. No. But he said Andy Warhol wants us to sing with that woman, and he said to the rest of the band, including Mo, he said, "Can you imagine a girl in the band?" And he said that to Mo, who's a girl, you know. So but I think she didn't care. She just banged her drums, and she was just, and you know, on that record as well, you have a beautiful cover of "Waiting for the Man," and many of her releases, she covered some. Voilà, you have "Pale Blue Eyes" sung by her heroine, and those versions are just brilliant. They're just very beautiful. She carried on. Once I met a friend. Good friend of mine who wrote a book about Pixies and said she kept the spirit of the Velvet Underground. She encapsulated it with fervor. Yes. So voilà. Donc, Questa, this is good. Okay, let's have. Do we have time to? I don't think we have time to play what I wanted to play. Do we have time? 22h30, ja. Gosh. I mean, we don't know. I mean about the. The latest video. Now I play that later on. Never mind. Apropos Nico, because yes, Nico, she was very beautiful. She was a very beautiful woman, Nico. We all know that. But apart from that, she was dark and she's just tragic. Tragic life. Beautiful songs. Wow. Something like, you know. Well, I can. What am I to say? Let's. Okay, I'm going to sing a song by Nico, if you don't mind. I put the glasses on because I might cry. I'm a very shy guy, and I don't want, you know. Alors, now we must be careful with the question of the lyrics, you know. So, the best thing to do would be to start with sol.
Si.
go for it.
Since the first of you and me asleep in a Nibelungen land, Titanic curses trap me in a banishment of stay. Symbols vanish from my senses, term and stave, the view appears. Symbols captured in a trance vanish from my glance, from the various defenses. I enforce a strike the alarm for the various defenses that choose to be here and there and lose the direction everywhere. Since the first of you and me asleep in a Nibelungen land where we cannot be, almond trees grow along the mountain trail, from their tongue the words are spelling the telling numb. I cannot hear it anymore, I cannot hear it anymore. Since the first of you and me here and there, we lose the direction everywhere. Shrinking city sun, shivering my veins, in flames I run, in flames I run, waiting for the sign to come. Will you spell the words for me? Will you spell the words for me to hear? Nibelungen, Nibelungen, Nibelungen land.
I was channeled with the spirit of Nico. Gosh, I never got so down and but in the depth. Beautiful, beautiful song. Okay, and you have a Nico favorite, so let's do it. Let's do it now. Sorry, we're running out of time. We have so many things to express, and there are so many things to say about all those people who wear the Velvet Underground, and you know.
It's one of her softer songs.
Cease to know what to tell, what to see, what to be your own. Cease to know what to tell, or to see, what to be your own. Have someone else's will as your own. Have someone else's will as your own. You are beautiful and you are alone. You are beautiful and you are alone.
Reward your praise.
just fine. No, just bravo, bravo.
Afraid.
Not only it's
the name of the song.
Afraid from the album.
Desert Shore.
A beautiful album produced by John Cale, along with the. It was part of the trilogy he produced from the 70s. The Marble Index, Is It Shore and the End. It is the end, beautiful friend. No, I'm making fun of. I'm not making fun of her. It's just she got so familiar in my life. You know, in terms of music, in terms of emotion, that, you know, with those people you can, you know, I'm making fun of Lou Reed, John Cale, I don't know how to do that accent.
You did a great Fear is a Man Best.
Yes, during an episode, in the season 2 of Le Compulsion Monologique de Joseph, I did a cover of Fear is a Man's Best Friend. It's beautiful.
And you dared to screaming. That's cool.
Yeah. Thank you. and this is nearly the end, beautiful friends. Okay, interesting. Let us see. There are so many things I wanted to share. We wanted to share, along with Benjamin, who, thank you very much for coming. Thank you for, you know, you accept. You come, you get a present, you know, and I have another present. I couldn't wrap it up. I don't know if you have it. We talked about journalists and all the shit they're doing now, but all the things they contributed. And I don't know if you have this very special. It was a supplement, petit supplement. In France, we say a supplement to magazine. Magazines, we say supplement of rock and folk. You know, rock and folk is a bit generally for the rock. Generally is a bit like, I don't know what you have in America or in England or China, wherever you're from. But it's rock and folk, which is, it's funny. I used to read that. It's the interview, a famous interview by Lester Bangs. Oh my gosh. Who was just a funny chap. And he liked Lou Reed, and he loved the Velvet Underground. He created this sort of love-hate relationship, but it was for the art of sake and the media and
is
all that.
Is it the one actually called "How I Comment Je Me Suis Battu avec Lou Reed sans m'endormir" or something like this?
Alors, you ask a lot. Comment je me suis cassé avec Lou Reed sans m'endormir une seule fois? You're absolutely right.
I love this text.
Great. This is my little present. This is up. Voilà. It's you come here to Les Compulsions Monologiques de Joseph. You play along. Things are happening. Lot of beautiful things are happening, and you get presents. Well, qu'est-ce que demander de plus que le monde que quoi? Qu'est-ce que tu veux de plus? For Christ's sake! I'm not kidding.
I mean, come on, man.
Oh no, it's just great. Thank you. And now. Alors, on continue. Alors, the good news, well, I'm going to put my shades on, is that, you know, I'm working on this... Attends, je vais mettre... Ouais, non, on n'a pas le temps. I'm working on this film, We Are Low Budget, about, you know, projection in a world dominated by silly Bowie fans, extreme Bowie fans. Imagine a world, France dominated by silly Bowie fans. Imagine it, it's possible. Everything's possible now. So this film is, it's work in progress. Because of like COVID and all that jazz, I lost, you know, I wasted time, and it takes a long time, and I also have a family to deal with, a family who is about to get bigger. That's one of the great news. Yes, I'm going to be a father again, father of another soul, who I have the privilege to welcome another soul. Thanks to Lord. Thank you, Jesus. And I like the song by the Velvet Underground. And thank you, Doug. Thank you, Lou. Thank you, everything that made that possible. And yes, the Velvet Underground. You know, one day we spoke about that. The Velvet Underground. When Lou Reed left, Doug kept on along with Maureen and Sterling. And then they left. Sterling left, and then Maureen left. And he found all other musicians. Someone, the guy Alexander something, and another one, I forgot the name. They were from Boston, I think. And the Velvet Underground existed. And then it stopped to exist because Dirk said, okay, now I know you no longer want to use this name. And then in 74, you know, when John Cale was working with Brian Eno And with Nico, they did that show, you know, on June 1974. Can't remember the date exactly, but they opened for the keyboard. Oh gosh, for Kevin Ayers.
Yeah.
And actually, there was this plan to recreate the Velvet Underground, to reform the Velvet Underground. So imagine Eno in a version of the Velvet Underground without Lou Reed. It's possible. We can have the Velvet Underground without Lou Reed. We can have it without John Cale. We can have it without any original members. So now I declare, and that's the wow. Là normalement, je check. Il devrait y avoir there should be music or something. So officiellement. In order, comment dire, I'm working, when I finish that We Are Low Budget based upon Bowie, that film, documentary film, I'm not talking about short film, I'm talking about something that will last 2 hours, 2 hours and a half or something. I'm talking serious, you know, I'm not freaking kidding, I'm not making pop art and all that jazz. The next film will be We Are The VU, because I officially say that the Velvet Underground exists again. So the Velvet Underground has reformed, and I am leading this reformation. So whether you want it or not, we are the Velvet Underground, along with Benjamin. I asked Benjamin, would you like to join the Velvet Underground? And he said, what did you say?
Yes, please.
So, okay, here we are. You might think, who the heck are those two French who claim to reform the Velvet Underground? And we don't care about what you may be thinking, because we know that we are the Velvet Underground. We are the VU. Va bene? So let us be clear. And you will hear about this very soon. Okay. Till up to New York. And voilà, I'm not freaking kidding. And now it's time for you, before we say goodbye, Apropos New York, in German they speak like that. Apropos. So let's go for it. From the album New York, 1989. A love song.
Three chords.
Sort of.
Take Manhattan in the garbage bag with Latin written on it.
Great. Very, very good. Very, 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 very good. Well, now it's time. We went through a lot of things. And I know that some of you guys may be able to understand what we want to mean, you know. Because we were not just performing and trying to have a good time. If you didn't get it, well, too bad for you. Now, our last song before we say goodbye. Allez, let's pretend it's yesterday, 1990, when Lou Reed and John Cale got together in order to pay tribute to Andy Warhol, who died a couple of years before. J'avais quand même un tac 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 tac. Toi, t'as très bon phrasé là sur Romeo had Juliet.
Merci. Je peux
et ça sert à ça. C'est appétissant. Ouais. Maintenant. Those words are so wow, so fancy. We want to eat them all. You know, they are sucrery. So, où on en est là? Tac tac tac. Qu'est-ce qui reste? Tac, dear Andy. I guess we gotta go. Va bene. And we do it together. And attends, I just have, voilà. Okay, and I'm going to use the tape. I just found that in an old box. I found the tape, you know, when I bought it, it was tape, good old tape. And I read the lyrics, because, you know, I need to remove the silly glasses.
We used to have tapes with lyrics on it.
Definitely, look at that. Well, it's called Hell, It's Me. We haven't rehearsed. You saw that. We have rehearsed a few songs, like Jesus, and I messed up the solo. But all the other songs, we haven't rehearsed them. Like, we are the Velvet Underground. We don't bother rehearsing. Do you think we have time to rehearse? We have other things to deal with.
Exactly.
We have women to take care of.
Yeah.
We have kids soon, apparently very soon. Apparently you're going to have a kid, because my kid said, he said that you're going to have a kid.
Yeah.
So I trust my kid, because it's my kid. And we are the Velvet Underground. Thanks for watching. And see you real soon. Hello, it's me. I really miss your mind. I haven't heard ideas like that for such a long, long time. I love to watch you draw and watch you paint. But when I saw you last, I turned away.
When Billy Lane was sick and locked up in his room, you asked me for some speed. I thought it was for you. I'm sorry if I doubted your good heart. Things always seem to end before they start.
Hello, it's me. That was a great gallery show. Your cow wallpaper and your floating silver pillows. I wished I paid more attention when they laughed at you. Hello, it's me.
Pop goes pop artist, the headline said, is shooting a poodle, is Warhol really dead? You get less time for stealing a car. I remember thinking as I was hearing Mono record in the bar.
They really hated you, now all that's changed. But I have some resentments that can never be unmade. Hit me where it hurts, I didn't love. Your diaries are not a worthy epitaph.
Well now, Wendy, I guess we have to go.
I hope some way, somehow,
you'll like this little show. I know it's late in coming, but it's the only way I know. Hello, it's me. Good night.
Everyone, thanks for watching, and remember, we are the VU. Ok, bon, je crois qu'on peut terminer là-dessus. Voulez-vous vraiment terminer le flux? Fin. Oh gosh.